Some of you probably already knew, nearly 100 million people were lifted out of extreme poverty at the end of 2020, thanks to the decades-long poverty alleviation project carried out here. But does that mean less attention will be given to rural regions? Of course not. At the very beginning of 2023, China released its number one central document. It is the first policy document and also indicates the priority of policies. And once again, this document highlights working on rural issues. For 20 years since 2004, working on rural issues has been on China's number one central document. Hello guys, I'm Li Jingjing, here covering China's annual most important political meeting, the two sessions. This is my vlog. If you want to understand real China, if you want to understand China's policies, make sure you follow my coverage.
There are three steps for China's rural revitalization strategy. First, eradicating poverty, and China already did that.
Many deputies I've talked to told me the remarkable improvement the poverty alleviation project has brought to their hometowns.
13年左右以前我们的就是每户都是瓦房嘛，都是这种土木结构，人畜混居的这样一个住房情况。当时水平生活水平也达不到那么高嘛，就在一楼的时候建个可小阁楼，地层底下来养猪养鸭，然后上面咱们再居住。但是现在基本上都是就是咱们脱贫攻坚的推进，异地扶贫的搬迁，还有危房改造的实施，这种情况现在已经是基本上没有了，到现在的一个农村小别墅、小洋楼的一个很明显的一个变化。
Second, achieving decisive progress on rural revitalization by 2035, and be fully rejuvenated with well-off farmers and strong agriculture sectors by 2050. To achieve those, a series of policies came out to promote breakthroughs in agricultural technologies and green development. So one major job of those deputies is bringing proposals to further develop their regions. The number of deputies coming from peasant or worker background also says a lot about the priorities. For example, among the 2,977 deputies this year, 497 are frontline workers or peasants.
They're bringing the issues their regions are still facing to the national level, hoping to put them into policies.
我们来以前就是反映了咱们基层聚走办了咱们基层的一些群众，现在制约咱们县现在是高速路已经通了嘛，然后高速路已经通，但是我们的铁路目前还是一个空白网的状态。对，我们也提了一条说关于建设我国面向南亚、东南亚重要辐射交通要道云南保山至连山段铁路的一个建设意见。
Better education is crucial for bringing prosperity to people in rural regions. So I talked to this deputy, who is a teacher.
我是第四届，想想啊，第四届就是已经因为五年一届嘛，已经当了十五年，然后今年是第十六年吗？
是的，太厉害了，太厉害了。过去的十五年呢，我提了240份议案和建议。 那这其中呢，有半数以上都是事关教育发展，教育是阻断代际贫困的一个非常重要的一个举措。那么，孩子们只有接受了好的教育，他们才能拥有更好的未来，因为教育给他打开了看世界的窗口。那么国家一直重视乡村教育，希望乡村的孩子们也通过
接受良好的教育，也就是入口这样的工勤，能够让他们人生将来一样能够出彩。
Thanks to the years of dedication from people like Ms. Li and Ms. Zhang, China successfully eradicated absolute poverty.
As China is building a modern socialist country, China will keep revitalizing its rural regions.